Hello, beloved. Shalom. God bless you all. Hallelujah. Glory be to the Lamb of God. Hallelujah. Glory be to the Lamb of God. My God, Jesus Christ, Yeshua HaMashiach, the one that saves our life, the one that died for our sins. We just give him all the, you know, the glory and honor. We love the Father and the sweet Holy Spirit and all the things that all three does for us as one. Hallelujah. We just love the Lord here. You know, it's just so it's a privilege to be a daughter and a son of the Most High God. Hallelujah. Nevertheless, let's get straight into a few scriptures that the Lord has placed upon my heart. And the topic today is going to be running the race of faith. Hallelujah. Running the race of faith. Hallelujah. So wherever you guys are viewing me from around the world, I want to let you guys know that I do love you so much. And I pray that God does intercede for everything that your heart's desire. And I pray that the voice of the Lord will activate loudly in the Father's ear. Hallelujah. So he can, I'm hearing downfall, I mean, as in download, drop of some great things into your spirit, into your life, whether it's women that's going to be prophesying, men that's going to be prophesying, or you know, having the gifts of healing. That's what I'm hearing right now in the Spirit of God. I'm just doing all the great things and the great works in the Lord. And I pray that with every word that God gives you, that will pierce your heart and also pierce the heart of the people, so you can bring these lost souls that are in, that does not believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of God, Yeshua HaMashiach, the Son of God. I mean, they don't believe that the Lord is our Savior of the world. So we just pray that whatever word that the Father placed in your spirit to speak to a man or a woman or either God's people, the lost sheep, hallelujah, that needs to be pulled up into the bin for the Lord, I pray that you will be a deadly weapon to the enemy, that you can pierce these people's hearts and bring them in, says the Lord. Hallelujah. Nevertheless, so tonight, today's topic, hallelujah, is running the race of faith. Hallelujah. Is running the race of faith. Hallelujah. All right, so we're going to jump right into the scriptures. I'm going to say it like the Lord told me to say it. And the first one comes from 2 Timothy 2 and 5. And that's the main scripture that really jumped off everything else that I'm going to release. Hallelujah. All right, and it says, anyone who competes in the race is not crowned unless he competes according to the rules. Okay. Hallelujah. I'm going to read again. Anyone who competes in the race is not crowned unless he competes accordingly to the rules. All right. So right here, the Lord is saying that, you know, we have to run the race of Christ. Hallelujah. The race of faith accordingly and correctly of how Yah says it. Okay. Hallelujah. Once again, we are to run this good race of faith. All right. All right. This good race in Christ. Hallelujah. Correctly and accordingly to how Yah says it. All right. Not how we think it should be. Okay. Not how we say it, but according to how Yah says it. Hallelujah. We don't decide how we are to, supposed to live. Okay. We do not decide, how to be holy. Hallelujah. We don't decide either also how to be made holy. Hallelujah. The instructions are in the Bible, says the Lord. All right. So we don't make the rules here. Hallelujah. So whenever you are put into a race, which is the race of grace, which is the race of Christ, which is the race of faith, God is saying that you have to compete and run in order to receive your crown. You have to compete and run accordingly to his rules. We don't make the rules here. Hallelujah. We just abide by it. Because the Holy Spirit will tell you what to do. Hallelujah. That's what I'm hearing right now. And also the instructions of the law, the instructions of the land, the instructions of God is in the Bible. All right. And we know that the Bible was written many years ago, before our time. All right. Hallelujah. So we don't change the Bible. We don't change the word. We don't change anything. The only changer is Yahweh, says the Lord. All right, so when we don't do this, hallelujah, nevertheless, we don't receive a reward. We don't receive blessings. We don't even receive a crown. Hallelujah. And I don't know if you guys know this or not, but there are five crowns in this race. I can't think of all of them, but it's a crown of righteousness. There's a crown of glory. There's a crown of life. And there's two other more crowns I can't think about right now, but that's what I'm kind of led to say. But there are different crowns that the Father will crown you according to where you are at in Him. Hallelujah. But your ultimate crown should be the crown of glory. You're making it home, and God gives you that crown to be placed on your head as He's judging the other people that are standing right behind you. So when He calls your name up to the throne, hallelujah, on the last day of judgment, you should want to be one of those people that's going to receive the crown of glory. Hallelujah. All right. Next scripture comes from 1 Corinthians 9:24. 1 Corinthians 9:24. Hallelujah. Y'all give me 1 second. I'm going to pull up my tablet. All right. So 1 Corinthians 9:24 speaks about self-discipline. Okay. Hallelujah. All right. So I'm going to read this and I'm going to break it down how the Holy Spirit tells me to say it. All right. So it says, do you not know that in a race, all the runners run, but only one gets the prize? Run in such a way as to get the prize. Everyone who competes in the games goes into strict training. All right. So whenever we are running this race in faith, whenever the Lord starts the process, hallelujah, we are competing to win in a good way. We are competing to win, but we also are what? We are also under strict training. Hallelujah. Why is the training strict, prophets? Because we are supposed to be lined up with the word of God. Remember earlier, the Lord said that we don't make the rules. You know, we didn't make the rules in the Bible. We don't make the rules. We have to live how and accordingly how the Father says to live. Okay, so that's why the training is strict. Hallelujah, because we don't make it. God does not give us anything easy. God will not put nothing on us more than we can bear. But He makes the rules. That's why it says self-discipline. All right, we are to discipline ourselves. Why? Because it's not us making the rules. So if someone else is making the rules and giving you instructions to follow, that means you are not coming from your own self, your own mind, your own spirit, but it's coming from the Spirit of the living God, right? Hallelujah. So therefore, it makes it you have to go by somebody else's ways and laws and rules and instructions. So that's why it's called discipline. Okay? All right? They do it to get a crown that would not last. So now let's go back to what the scripture is really saying. All right. So Paul is saying, you know, some people compete for the wrong thing. So they do it to get, I'm hearing right now, a favorable crown. All right. A favorable crown is like, from what I'm seeing now, is a worldly crown. They're doing it to please the people and not God. So they're doing it to grant favor from the people and not God. But Paul is saying tonight that won't last. If you receive a favorable crown from a man, that won't last. You run a rat race, says the Lord. Nothing is easy but cheesy when you are running a race for man and not God. Hallelujah. Okay, but we deny, I'm sorry, he says, but we do it to get a crown that will last forever. And that's the crown I was telling you guys about, that last crown when the Lord said, come on in, our good faithful servant, well done. And it says, therefore, I do not like someone running aimlessly. All right, so aimlessly means without purpose or direction. So as we run this good fight of faith, as we run this good race of faith, we should have a purpose and a plan and a direction by Yahweh, says the Lord. Hallelujah. Here it says, I do not fight like a boxer beating the air, nor I strike a blow to my body and make it my slave, so that after I have preached to us, I myself would not be disqualified for the prize. Hallelujah. So Paul is saying he does not cheat to win, but he does things accordingly to the environmental instructions of God. So however the Lord says it, that's how Paul runs it, says the Lord. Hallelujah. All right. I want to go to Habakkuk 2 and 2. Hallelujah. And I'm not going to read it because you guys know that this is a popular text. So right here, the Lord said, when we first come to God, all right, and we are in the middle of our process, all right, and right here, I feel like I'm helping somebody tonight when I say this, because I said in the middle of your process, all right, and I know this is a testimony for me, because I know in the middle of my process, the Lord gave me my vision, and he told me to make it plain and go run with it, okay, so I'm going to read again. So the Lord said, when we first come to God, and we are in the middle of our process, Yah will release a vision on tablets for our lives, and we are to receive it, and the Lord expect us to run with it. My God. It said, write the vision and make it plain. Hallelujah. But the vision comes from the Spirit of God. God will give you a vision. And as he is downloading to your mind, your spirit, you are to write it down and then study it, examine it, pray into it, so the Father can give you further direction and information to make it plain. My God. And this normally happens in the middle of our process, says the Lord. And that is for somebody right there. Hallelujah. You are in the middle of your process, hallelujah, and God has been downloading information about your ministry, about your vision and your dream, and you have been catacornered in the middle of your mess, hallelujah, and has been, I'm hearing the word, taken aside and has been confused about it. But I come to tell you tonight, beloved, that it is God, hallelujah, and I pray tonight that God will erase the false memory that I'm seeing right now over your mind, and to restore this vision on these tablets for you tonight. Hallelujah. So you can pick up your tablets and run, says the Lord. Hallelujah. My God. My God. Hallelujah. Lord God, thank you for the revealing. Hallelujah. All right, so now let's go to Hebrews 12 and 1. Hebrews 12 and 1. All right, so Hebrews 12 and 1 says, therefore we also, since we are surrounded by so great a cloud of witness, let us lay aside every weight and the sin which so easily ensnares us, and let us run with endurance the race that is set before us. So nevertheless, let's put down anything that hinders us from God. Hallelujah. And push and deliver through the race. Hallelujah. God wants to take you through leaps and bounds. Hallelujah. So we need to push through the race. We need to put down those idols, when you put out those distractions, those hindering spirits, anything that's caused you not to be close to God, put it down. Hallelujah. And push and deliver the purpose and plans for your life that is instructed through the race that you're running for God. Hallelujah. God wants to take you through leaps and bounds. He wants to take you through the leaps and bounds to get you to your next designation, to the Lord. All right. I was pausing because I was trying to hear God. I thought he was saying something else. All right. Hallelujah. Last text is going to come from 2 Timothy 4 and 7. And it says, I have fought the good fight. I have finished the race. I have kept the faith. When it's all done and said, beloved, you want to go to the throne of God. Oh, shede buhu abaha. You want to go to the throne of God on your last breath of life. And you want to be able to lift up your hands and say, God, I have fought the good fight. I have run this race for you, And for your people, I have kept my faith. Hallelujah. And you want to hear the Father said, well done, my good and faithful servant. Take your crown and come on into glory. Hallelujah. Well, I love you guys so much with the heart of Christ. I hope this message encouraged you guys. Keep running the good race of faith. Keep moving forward in the things of God. You have so much ahead of you, so much of greatness ahead of you, so much of things and praises and people that God wants you to touch. Hallelujah. But if you give up now, you won't make it. Hallelujah. If you give up now, you will not make it. You won't see the promise. You won't see the things of Yahweh that he has been stored for you since your birth. Hallelujah. And also, when you run this race, follow the instructions. Do it just as the Lord is saying. Do it just as the Holy Spirit is speaking to your spirit. Stay in the guidelines of Yahweh. Because the Lord said tonight that we don't make our own rules. Who are we to say how to live holy? Who are we to say how to be justified? Who are we to say this and that? Who are we? It's Yahweh, the Father, that has written these scriptures for us. Hallelujah. Through man that he has entrusted men with. But the words came through the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. So the book was made by Yahweh because they was hearing the Father's voice. So whenever we are running this race, we are expecting to receive our ultimate crown. We are expecting to receive that crown of glory. You want to make it to the finish line in completeness, says the Lord. And that completeness scripture again is 2 Timothy 4:7. Lord God Jesus, Yeshua HaMashiach, glory to the Lamb of God. Oh, Shede Boho, Yahweh the Father, I have fought the good fight. Oh, I have fought the good fight of grace. I have fought the good fight. I have finished the race. Here's my ticket, Father. I'm turning my ticket into you, Father. I'm done. I am checking in into my eternal place. Hey. Yeah. Oh, thank you, sweet Holy Spirit, for taking us in. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for holding us there. Thank you, Father, for accepting us as your children. In Jesus' mighty, great name. Hallelujah. Let the church and the people of God say amen. Well, I love you, beloveds. I love you so much. I will be back. Good night. Good night. Good night. Good night. Shalom. Salam. I will be back.